Oh, listen, I love this script, but if we don't find the right man to play the part of Jesus, honey, they'll crucify us.
Don't frown. It just makes you look so old. Max, number 86.
My name is Arnie.
Okay, Arnie, why don't you be Jesus in scene 4 where he's cleaning out the temple? He's a teensy-weensy bit frustrated, and you could use a prop to clean with. How about a broom?
How about a whip? You ought to be ashamed of yourself. My father's house is a house of prayer. You flabby bunch of hypocrites, you've made it a den of thieves. You better hear me now and believe me later. Clean it up now, because I'll be back.
It's too strong a Jesus for me.
Thank you, Arnie. You're beautiful. You can go. We'll be in touch. Next, number 87.
Hi, my name is Tom.
Right, Tom, why don't you be Jesus there? Take it from the bottom of scene 6. I think Jesus is saying, I am something.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. And no man can come to the Father unless he comes through me.
Cut! Tell him to stick to the script.
Tom, babe, the script says, I am one of many ways, truths, and lives that you may choose. No one can come to my spirit force without using someone like me as an example, right?
But that's not the way it's written in the Bible.
Tell him that this is Hollywood.
This is Hollywood.
We don't care what the Bible says.
We don't care what the Bible says.
We've got our own script.
But if you're not trying to show Jesus the way that he really was, then why bother to do this?
Get rid of the religious fanatic.
Thank you, Tom. You're beautiful. We'll call you sometime. Of course, I don't know just exactly what we'll call him.
Oh, is it too much to ask? I just want to create my own kind, loving, and tolerant Jesus.
I know you do. We all do.
Oh.
Next. Now, this boy has got something. I don't think they have a cure for it yet.
I see. I like. He's magic. Lanny, if he did a miracle, I'd flip. Tell him to do his Sermon on the Mount.
Babe, you can do whatever you like. We'd like to see your Sermon on the Mount.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall make peace. World peace. Visualize world peace and save the whales.
Gives me chills.
I love you. That is a wrap. Total wrap. Just wrap him up, put a bow on him, and bring him over here to me.
I think with this young man, we can create a Jesus that the whole world will buy, one that everyone in their hairdresser can accept.
Jesus Christ is God, and Hollywood can't change that, no matter what they do. He wasn't some kind of a wimp. Jesus Christ, he was tougher than nails.
Tom, brother, hey, man, great job as Jesus today. I got a program I'd love you to play Jesus on.
Well, thanks, but what kind of show is it? Is it like a live stage show, like Toymaker's Dream?
No, it's almost live on videotape. It's Fire by Night! My name is Blaine Bartel. It's good to have you with us. Guess who our special guest is this time? None other than Michael W. Smith. And we're going to be world premiering two of his brand new music videos. We're going to be talking about Jesus Christ, Tougher Than Nails. Hey, let's get right into it.
Thank you. thought you ran home to Daddy. I didn't expect to see you back so soon. Of course, your gang's been expecting you to return for quite some time now.
That time hasn't come yet. Good thing for you. I've come to deliver a message.
I've got a message for you, too. I'm sick and tired.
I know, and I'm healing in strength.
Let me finish. I'm sick and tired of your boys harassing and tormenting my boys.
I've come to remind you about Acts chapter 2. I've poured out my spirit upon all flesh, and I've deputized some mighty young men with a fire that cannot be quenched.
Listen, I don't want to have to hear about any more fires that cannot be quenched.
Have you heard the one about the worms that won't die?
Yes, I'm so sick of it!
Your days are numbered, punk. And this new group of young guns won't be stopped.
They can't! They can't! It's not fair! I've worked on this for centuries! This territory's mine! They gave it to me!
Either taking it back in the name of yours truly, you're going down.
Jesus! You son of God, you! It won't be that easy! This second won't happen!
Go ahead. Make my last days.
A favorite of, I'm sure, almost every one of you that are watching a program today. His name is Michael W. Smith. Michael, thank you for being with us on Fire of the Night.
Good to be here.
Why don't you tell us, because I don't know this, and I'm sure a lot of young people that may be watching that don't know this, how did you get your start in contemporary Christian music? Bring us back to the beginnings a little bit for you.
Okay. Make a long story short, I grew up in West Virginia. I grew up in a very musical family, and started playing piano at a very young age and was really into sports all my life, but as I grew older, really developed a love for music. And I moved to Nashville, which was only about a 6-hour drive from West Virginia where I live, in 1978 to be a songwriter. And luckily, maybe I could get a cut, you know, maybe I can cut a record someday. So, I made the move to Nashville and waited tables, worked at Coca-Cola, you name it. I did all the little odd jobs to pay the bills. And got a break in 1980 and got my first songwriting contract. And a year later ran into a young girl named Amy Grant and got involved with her, writing songs for her, and opened up for Amy. And here we are, you know, 7-8 years later. It all seemed to happen so fast.
And friends are friends forever if the Lord's the Lord of them. It's hard to let you go. In the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live as friends.
You have gone very quickly to the top of the field in Christian music, and yet just in spending the last day or so with you, and I know with our crew, you're just a down-to-earth guy who just wants to work for the Lord. How have you been able to keep your success in perspective like you have?
I would say probably a big word that's probably been my favorite word in the past year or two has just been accountability. I think that's where it's at. I'm real close to my pastor in Nashville, Don Finto. I feel like all the core and group of people that we have at Reunion Records, there's a real family feel there. My managers, Mike Blanton and Dan Hill, who I mentioned earlier, there's just a real accountability there of, like, I feel like if I start going off the deep end, I've given those guys complete freedom to just wring me by the neck and pull me back in here and give me a slapping around, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. And I think you need that. I think there's a lot of people that are out there just kind of coasting and don't want anybody to, they don't want anybody around them, you know what I'm saying? They kind of want to do their own thing. And boy, that's you can really fall fast when you're alone in this thing. And so I think it's the kind of people you hang around with, and it's accountability, that's where it's at.
alleys and stuff like that, he'd make them more beautiful now than it is.
Dressed like one of us.
Well, he'd probably be just like he always was. I mean, he probably wouldn't be anything different.
Well, getting rid of, you know, all these satanic people, and maybe go and clean out Columbia. And
he would be saving souls. He would be casting out demons.
Like undercover agent or something like that.
Yeah, I think the flowers would bloom brighter, the grass would grow greener, everything would be more beautiful.
What would Jesus be like if he was walking the earth today? I believe that the Word of God has an answer for that. It says in the book of Hebrews, chapter 13, verse number 8, Jesus Christ, the same, yesterday, today, and forever. You know, Jesus has never changed, and he never will. And yet the world has tried to change him. I've seen some of these paintings that they paint of Jesus, and they make him look like some kind of girl, like he was some kind of wimp. And I've got to believe that when young people see paintings like that, that they say, man, what kind of Jesus is that? Who wants to follow that if that's what Jesus was really like? You know, you see some of these movies that have come out and portray Jesus as some kind of weakling, as a person who struggled with his own identity. And I want you to know that Jesus was not like any of these things. Jesus had a purpose and he had a cause. Jesus was tough, man. He was a carpenter. He wasn't some kind of wimp. I mean, he was a modern-day construction worker. He had nails put through his hands and his feet. He was a tough guy. Jesus attracted the masses. Thousands of people would gather around him. He was revered by the people of that day. And I want you to know if you follow Jesus, you can be tough too. You can be tougher than sin, tougher than persecution, tougher than the devil's crown. Live for him, and Jesus Christ will be powerful in you.
Listen, I'm just so excited we finally found our Jesus. I feel like I'm just floating in midair.
Oh, let's just float on over and do lunch with Martin.
Will you look at this? TV evangelist gives $100,000 to America's homeless. Give me a break. Where'd he get all that money? Well, he probably got it from the homeless. And that's why they're homeless, is because he took all their money. This whole religion thing is such a scam.
What's wrong with helping some needy people?
Please.
Hey, most Christians are really sincere.
Yeah, well, I've never met one, thank you.
Well, okay. I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Mike, a sincere Christian.
Here it comes.
Yeah, right. Jesus is real, and he loves you.
Right. I'm sure he does.
You don't believe me, do you?
Look, I don't want to hear your sweet little Jesus story, okay? What floor are we on?
Evidently, you don't realize what Jesus did for you and who he is.
Look, I have a lot of other things on my mind. I'm sure Jesus has done a lot of things for you, but he hasn't done anything for me.
Now that's where you're wrong. Jesus suffered a cruel death on a cross. Has anybody else died for you?
Nobody has to die for me. I like my life the way it is. Do I look like I need someone to die for me?
Christian music. This summer was filled with gospel music festivals all over the United States and Canada, but August marked the very first Christian music festival in the Soviet Union. The lineup included Sheila Walsh, Scott Wesley Brown, Paul Smith, and Bruce Carroll. Now it's time for our Five Right Night Top 10 Countdown. Here's some dates for the Petra, Josh McDowell, Why Wait Tour.
people in the United States that really believe in Jesus. I mean, if you go up and ask someone, oh yeah, I believe Jesus, you believe the Son of God? Yeah, he's the Son of God. But yet, in America, we have such a moral decline, we have a country that believes in him and yet doesn't practice what he taught. Why is that in the United States today? And is there something we can do to begin to change that?
I think we've got in this spirit of religiosity, really. You know, it's, I think we've grown up, at least me anyway, I grew up in a society where you went to church, and if you go Sunday morning and Sunday night, and maybe Wednesday night, if you were a Church of Christ, mm-hmm. you know, then you were cool, you know, and it was something that wasn't discussed much, and your spirituality or whatever was always it was a private thing. It's nothing that we could talk about, you know. That's the kind of culture I grew up in, although I have great parents who really taught me a lot about the Lord, but it was just nothing that was never discussed much. So I think a lot of people have grown up in this thing, hey, if I do the good deed trip, you know, I'll be fine. And it's not based on good deeds. You can try to be good the rest of your life, and it's never going to get you to heaven.
Yeah.
It's all a grace thing, you know. So we're in deep trouble. When you look at the churches today and you look and see what's happening. Now, I try to see the positive side of things, too, when I see what's happening here and seeing a lot of churches on the move, that good, great things are happening. People are beginning to see that there really is life in all this thing.
Yeah.
But there's been some really, it's really wild. We have been to a lot of places. And there's something really happening. I even feel it in here. There's really something happening. There's something happening all over the country. It's a movement! And I'm here to tell you, we want to be a part of that movement. It has really blown our minds to see how people are being affected. I say all this to tell you that myself and all these guys back here, we have had a major, major encounter with Jesus, and we have not been the same since.
But we've all got to somehow unify as one body. There's a lot of separation between churches and all this sort of thing, and we're all scattered about. We've got to come together as one. And I feel like when we really see that, I think you're going to see the power of God move across America. Definitely had a change in my life. I became a Christian when I was 10, and really struggled when I got out of high school. I thought I'd missed out on all the good years and all that sort of thing, and got into the whole drug thing for 2 or 3 years, which I still can't believe I did, and I'm not proud of it at all. But God really had a hold on my life when I gave my life to Him at 10. I mean, I had a change in my life, and I still, through all the craziness and through all those years, I couldn't run away from it. God had a hold on my heart. I've just had a change. I mean, I think if I had to say something to you all out there, I would say that, again, this is not a good deed trip. I mean, it's actually a personal relationship with Jesus that has affected me, you know. I mean, it's just, I feel like I've got a relationship with the God of the universe, and I think you're never really going to understand that until you give your life to Him. And I think when you do that, you're going to look back and say, boy, why did I wait around so long?
Nobody knew his secret ambition. Nobody knew his claim to fame. He broke the old rules deep in tradition.
We'll be right back.
Nancy Small with the Tribune. I've asked you all to come here today because I want to get your reaction to Jonathan Baptist.
Kathy, God is love.
You hypocrite! You say you have repented, yet we see no change in your life. You have not repented. Scribe, reporter, you who expose the dirt and sin of other people's lives, why do you not expose the sin of your own lives? Why do you pretend to be clean? You are as graveyards. On the outside, polished and manicured, but on the inside, you are full of death. I want to be baptized. I am a sinner. God, forgive me. I baptize you as a sign of your turning from your sins. Behold, the Lamb of God, whose blood pays for the sin of this world.
Yo, cuz.
Cut, cut. Dougie, Dougie, Dougie. Look, Jesus wouldn't say, yo, cuz.
Yes, he would, Clarence. I mean, Jesus and John the Baptist were cousins.
Yeah, I know, but that's not what we're trying to get across here, okay?
Well, listen, what kind of video are we doing? If Jesus were to walk the earth today, video. And if he was to walk the earth, he wouldn't say, here am I. He'd say, yo, cuz.
Well, maybe something like that, but it's getting awful late, and the Vice Squad's going to be here any minute. So can we just get on with it?
Okay.
Okay, everybody, stand by. Action.
Woman, where is the Vice Squad, your accuser?
They split, Lord, beginning with the one closest to retirement.
Then neither do I press charges. Go, call your parents and be a runaway no more. Oh, that's so good. You did it perfect. Every line was there. I need to put a little powder on you. Oh, wasn't that good, John?
Don't come to me looking for approval. I don't like the idea of Connie acting like a prostitute in any way, shape, or form.
Oh, Dad, don't think of me as a prostitute. Just think of me as a runaway prostitute.
Connie, only Clarence could have come up with a project like this.
Oh, this is a great project. It's going to be a testimony to the whole senior class.
Yeah, Dad, and if Clarence wins, he gets to go to the national contest.
I think that you are a little upset with Clarence because he wouldn't let you be John the Baptist.
No.
No?
No.
No?
No.
No problem.
No problem.
Good.
He should have given me a chance. At those tryouts, I was the only one that had his own camel-haired girdle.
Dad, Clarence said that your legs were too white and put a glare in the camera. Hello?
I'd have bought a membership to a tanning salon if they'd have given me half a chance.
No, Mr. Weaver. Clarence isn't here, but I can give you the number to his remote.
Well, of course. Give me his number.
That's Weaver, the teacher that gives them so much trouble that almost blocked them from having their morning Bible study.
55J-ESUS.
What did he want?
He wanted Clarence, and it didn't sound good.
Sounds good to me. He can have Clarence.
Dad!
John?
Crying out loud. I'm just kidding. I want Clarence's video project to go well.
Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand.
Okay, disciples, go ahead and get in place.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hypocrites. Hypocrites. We need more hypocrites. We got more disciples than hypocrites.
That'll be the day.
Okay, y'all go ahead and get in place, okay? If Jesus were alive today, TV Productions, producer Clarence Stanley speaking. Are you a hypocrite? No, Mr. Weaver, no, sir. I wasn't talking about you, sir. Yes, sir, what can I do for you, sir?
Listen, Stanley, I just finished looking over the manuscript for your project, and I'm calling to let you know it is officially canned.
Canned? What do you mean, canned? I'm sure we can work something out. Like we'll have my machine call your machine, and they'll do lunch? Yes, sir. Okay, sir, I'll be there in 15 minutes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you very much. Okay, everybody, we're gonna take kind of a short lunch, kind of a long lunch break. We'll meet back here at about 2:30, okay?
Clarence, what is the problem?
Well, that was Weaver on the phone, man. He's gonna can the whole project. Oh, but I know, I'll just butter him up.
What if he's on a diet?
Well, I'll use something aside from butter, but just remember, it's not over till the fat lady sings. There's no business.
like show business like no.
Thank you. Thank you. The history of Broadway will make an excellent project. You've got my approval.
Thank you. Mr. Weaver, king of biology, how you doing? Anybody ever tell you that you look a lot like President Bush?
Don't try buttering me up, Stanley. There's nothing you can say that'll make me change my mind. You are not going to use tax money and school property to propagate your religious beliefs, and especially not under the guise of a senior project.
But it's too late. You told me that I could do a historical project on a historical man.
Stanley, men like George Washington, Abraham Lincoln, Adolf Hitler, even Michael Jackson are historical men, but Jesus Christ, do you realize what kind of controversy you'll stir up? I'm not putting my job on the line for something I don't even believe in. I'm going to change the theme, and that's all. Now, where's the equipment?
It's out on location.
You only have the equipment through the remainder of today. I want it here first thing in the morning.
Well, now, wait a minute. Then I can have the rest of the day to finish my project, because I know if you see the finished product that you'll change your mind.
Stanley, this is really getting irritating. No one is going to see your finished product. You're going to change the theme. In fact, I'll be out later on this afternoon to check and make sure you're making progress. Hey, how about if Mahatma Gandhi walked the earth today? Yeah, there's one you can sink your teeth into.
I just can't understand how Mr. Weaver has the power to can this whole project. I mean, I wish Mrs. Moore was our teacher on this project. She'd let us do it. Think of the impact this would have had if Jesus was walking the earth today. I mean, it would have ministered to people. And I was doing such a great job at playing Jesus, huh?
Mr. Weaver's just a tool in the devil's hand. All we need to do is bind Satan and believe God for his favor.
Connie, you just took the words right out of my mouth.
My thoughts exactly.
Let's pray right now. Come on, you guys. Father, in the name of Jesus, you said in Mark 11:24 that anything that we ask for and desired, if we pray believing, we would receive it. And we desire to see this project completed, Lord, to see it minister to people, and we ask you for it. We thank you. It's done in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. It's done, you guys.
You know what we're doing is so neat. Just think if people really did see Jesus face to face. Like, what if we saw him right now?
Well, I know what I'd do. In a split second, I would be flat on my face, just praising and worshiping God. You know, kind of conscious, but yet unconscious, but still conscious.
Yeah, face down. Me too.
You guys are so spiritual. Come on, Jesus is cool. He's a hip dude.
Oh, really? Well, what would you do, Mr. Smarty Pants?
Hey, I'd give Jesus some skin.
Doug, why would you want to give Jesus some of your skin?
All I know is that if we're going to get this puppy shot, we better shoot this puppy.
Oh, you're not going to shoot a puppy, are you? Just go do your video.
Oh, Doug, man, check this guy out. You think he'd go home to sleep?
Clarence, the guy's a bum. He's a street person. I mean, this probably is his home right here. Hey, buddy, you doing all right? Watch your manners.
Hey, bud, you got a buck? Don't give it to him, Doug. He'll probably just buy a wine cooler or something. Why don't you get a job?
No, really, listen, I just want something to eat.
Come on, Doug, we're doing the work of the Lord here. We got to get this puppy shot.
Okay, hey, man, God bless you. You just trust in Jesus, okay? He'll meet all your needs.
That's a little close on the fan there, dear.
Oh.
Thanks. Okay, everybody, places. Come on, let's go. We'll take it from Jesus' entrance. Baptist, are you ready? Jesus, you know your line.
Yes, I know my lines, Clarence. I come in, I say, John, will you baptize me?
That's close enough. Go ahead. Okay, places. Quiet on the set.
Hey, we lost a 2K.
Where?
By Doug.
Doug, could you, like, plug that back in for us? I think you might have tripped over it or something.
Be careful, there's water.
Clarence? Where am I?
Hello, Doug.
Oh, Jesus! Jesus! What am I doing here?
Doug, you can get up. You're all right, son. You're with me. You want me to give you some skin?
No,
No, that's okay. Am I dead? Why am I here?
Electricity's pretty powerful stuff, isn't it, Doug?
Oh, yes, it sure is. Of course, for me it is, not for you.
Yeah. Take a look at the monitor. That's you.
That's me. It is me.
There.
Get a blanket.
There it goes.
Yeah,
down
make
easy.
A pillow. Make a pillow with that part of the blanket.
I guess, I'm not gonna...
Doug, don't worry. Clarence is still praying for you.
Are you telling me that my life is hanging in the balance of Clarence's faith and prayers?
Well, not on his alone, but he does play an important part.
He does. Well, that's okay. I could learn to like it here.
Doug, it's good to have you here. I haven't heard from you in a couple of weeks.
I know. I've been kind of busy with...
Working on your video.
Yeah, and, I also had this...
paper due in biology.
How did you know? I know. You know everything. You know everything.
Like the swimsuit issue.
The swimsuit issue, yeah. I didn't open it. I just looked at the cover. I'm guilty. I that was wrong. I shouldn't have looked at the cover.
No, Doug, you shouldn't have. Not for 15 minutes.
I'm sorry. I repent.
It's sorry, Doug, and I forgive you.
Thank you.
Hey, Doug, things could have been different down there with that beggar.
Oh, you mean the man on the bench?
Look right here on the monitor, Doug. This is what I wanted to do. Roll it, Gabriel.
Doug, come on, man. We got to get going. We're doing the work of the Lord here. We got to get this thing shot.
Okay, hey, man, God bless you. You just trust in Jesus, okay? He'll meet all your needs.
See, Doug, right there. That's where the Holy Spirit was prompting you to share my love with that man. Gabriel, give us a tight on Doug's face. You remember that, Doug?
Yeah, I remember.
Now look what could have happened.
Clarence, is this the work of the Lord? Hey, bud. Here, take that. Get some food, okay?
Well, thanks.
Whoa. Hey, listen, that's probably not enough. Take that, too, okay? There you go.
I can't believe this. Nobody's ever given me a dollar before. Well, why are you doing this for?
Hey, I love you, okay? And even more than that, Jesus loves you. Jesus died on the cross for you. He rose from the dead to give you a brand new life. Listen, what's your name?
Trevor.
Trevor, have you ever asked Jesus Christ into your life before?
No, but listen, I know I need to.
Well, hey, we can do that right now. Do you want to pray?
Yeah, I guess so.
Okay. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Wow, what was that noise?
That's how the angels would have rejoiced if that man's soul had been saved.
Aw, man, did I ever miss God on that one. Well, I mean, I missed you. You know what I mean. Man, Lord, you've got a lot to worry about trying to answer every single person's prayers on the whole planet.
Doug, we don't worry up here. Any other questions?
Yeah. Yeah, the Russia-China conflict. I mean, you've heard about that, right? Well, of course you have. Is that in your will? Like, is that according to prophecy or what?
It is a problem. But do you want to see what I see right now?
Yeah.
I am not wanting to have rice again for lunch.
You foolish Russian. You eat rice. It is good for you. When I come to your country, you give me vodka to drink. I get so drunk, I don't know what treaty I sign.
Fine, you eat rice, I drink vodka. I don't keep stupid treaty anyway.
I have peace gift for you.
Oh, I am having peace gift for you too, my tongue.
Oh, Honorable Gorbachev, your humble servant, so grateful.
What in the name of Mao Zedong is this, my tongue?
Ancient Chinese secret. Head spot remover. Make head so clean, you can eat off of it.
I don't want to eat off my head. That does it. Now we will nuke Beijing. We will make Tiananmen Square look like Tiananmen Circle.
So, Lord, how in the world are you going to fix all this mess in China anyways?
I've got a good core of obedient followers, Doug, who pray when the Holy Spirit prompts them to, like your mom and dad.
So what do you guys want to do tonight?
Well, let's just do something fun.
What you guys need to do is get on your knees and pray.
Why don't we get on our skis and play?
Well, honey, why on earth did you say something like that?
I don't know.
Look at the headline news.
Have you seen my new line of shoes?
Doug, you're not the Holy Spirit. Let me talk to them. They know my voice. The voice of a stranger they will not follow.
Okay, go ahead.
Thanks, Doug.
Honey, this whole Russia China thing really grieves me. I feel like we need to get down on our knees and pray about that headline in the news.
There you go. All clean and shiny. Spotty's gone. See?
Thank you so much. Now, let's have some more rice.
Bring out vodka, too.
No, we not having to drink vodka to have good time. We eat rice.
Okay, sounds good to me.
My tongue, let me pause this. Let's not make war.
Okay, sounds good to me.
Wow, that's awesome, Lord, to think that my mom and dad actually affected the situation in China.
Yes, not only yours, but quite a few others.
Yeah. You know, this is really great being with you all the time. I mean, it's kind of cool hanging out together, huh?
It's fun hanging out with you too, Doug.
Yeah, you know, I don't ever want to go back. I mean, it's great being home and everything, with family and friends, a solid rock, Clarence's movie, but you know Clarence's movie? If I'm up here, well, who's going to be Jesus?
I am.
Yeah, you are. But what I meant, like, was, who's going to play Jesus in the video, you know, if there's going to be a video?
I seem to remember a prayer of faith in your bedroom.
Yeah, we prayed and we believed. But, you know, that Mr. Weaver, he's a mean guy.
Oh, no, it's all a front. You want to see him the way I see him? He's crying out to me.
Yeah.
There, look.
Oh, I'm so empty inside. There's got to be more than this. Oh, Lord. That poor guy, who's going to help him? And what about the movie?
Clarence.
Clarence?
I created him. I can use him. How about a trip into the future?
What do I do, Lauren?
Just watch. I'll give Clarence the words. Here they come.
Come on, Stanley. Get in the car. Sit down and be quiet. You've not paid a bit of attention to my warning. No one is going to see this video. You're wasting your time and mine. Your project is almost due, and this what if Jesus were alive today is completely unacceptable.
But Mr. Weaver, Jesus is a historical figure, and he's much more than that. He's alive today, working through his church body. He still saves people. He still heals people. Why, he could probably even heal your wife of cancer, couldn't he? Mr. Weaver? You are married, aren't you? Does your wife have cancer?
I don't understand this, Stanley. How did you find out? We only learned about this yesterday, and we haven't told anybody.
It must just be the Lord. Let me pray with you.
Well,
come on. Father, we just come before you in the name of Jesus, and Lord, I thank you that you love Mr. and Mrs. Weaver enough to die on the cross for them, and Lord, we just pray that you heal her of her cancer. And cancer, we just command you to be gone from her body in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I guess I might as well go ahead and return the equipment now, huh?
Look, Stanley, you've gone this far. There's no sense in wasting good videotape, so go ahead and finish your project. I'll accept it. By the way, thanks for your concern.
Wow, Jesus, what a great ending. Well, I guess Clarence's movie project's going to work out then, so I guess I'm going to have to...
That's right. You're going back.
Oh, I don't know if I want to go back. I mean, I think this is so great, you and I so close together like this.
Well, Doug, that doesn't have to change. In fact, I don't want it to change.
No, Hey, we're not going to change this. We're going to stay tight. I just got one question. Have I been dead all this time or what?
No, you're not dead. You fulfilled Acts 2:17. Read it.
Thank you. This is great. Acts 2:17. I wish you would have marked it for me. It's that in the New Testament, right? Okay. Here it is. Acts 2:17. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. That's you talking. And your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions. Are you kidding me? This is a vision. Wow, man, let's do this again sometime.
Sure, Doug. We will.
Okay. Well, I guess, where did I put my skateboard? Here it is. I guess I need to be going back. Just want to tell you something before I go. I probably don't tell you this enough, but I love you. I love you.
I love you too, Doug. Hey, everybody, he's okay. He's fine. Doug, man, are you okay? Do we need to take you to the hospital or anything?
Yeah, I'm okay, Clarence. I'm fine.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Well, you were unconscious for almost a minute.
Clarence, almost a minute? You wouldn't believe what I just saw.
Wow. Well, I really want to hear about it, but not right now. We're kind of busy. Hey, can we go on with the scene? I mean, do you feel up to it?
Yeah, I can do it.
Okay.
Stanley, I've been looking for you, young man. Come here.
It looks like this project's history.
No, it isn't, Clarence. Don't say that. You go get in that car. God will give you the words to say. Come on.
Okay.
Get in the car. Sit down and be quiet.
You know, the Bible says in the book of John, chapter 3, verse number 16, quite possibly the most well-known scripture in all of the Word of God. It says, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life." You know, God loved you and He loved me so much that He sent Jesus Christ into this world to die for my sins and for your sins. He didn't send an angel, something that He had many of, something that was disposable. He sent something that He only had one of, His Son Jesus. And I believe He looked at Jesus and He said, "Jesus, I want you to show this world what my love is all about." And the Bible says that Jesus came onto this earth, born of a virgin. And as He turned 30 years old, He went into His ministry. And for 3 years during His ministry, He healed the sick. Well, He went up to lepers who were missing their body parts, whose disease had just run rampant through their body, and He healed them. He went up to those that were deaf and those that were blind, and He gave them their sight and their hearing. He went up to prostitutes and forgave them and gave them a second chance. Jesus even loved the people that other people would ignore. He went up to children and picked the children up, and the Bible says that He blessed them. You know, His disciples said, "Just leave them alone." But I want you to know, Jesus cares about everybody, and He cares about you, and He loved us so much that He came to die on the cross for you and for me. And you know what? After 3 years of His ministry, you know what happened? The prostitute that had been forgiven, the leper that had been cleansed, the blind that had saw, they all shouted in unison, "Crucify Him! Kill Him! Take Him away! We don't want anything to do with Him! We don't care if He is the Son of God!" And they mocked Him, and they beat Him. And the Bible says, finally, that they took and they whipped Him with a whip that had many strands and many tails, and each one of these strands of leather had a sharp piece of rock or of bone or of glass, and as it would pierce into His skin, it would just rip His skin right out of His back. And the Bible says after that He was taken and He was put on a cross. He suffered for you and for me. And He walked up to a place called Golgotha with that cross. He fell over from exhaustion on His way up, it was so heavy. But when they got there, they nailed His feet and His hands with long spikes into the cross, and they hoisted the cross up, and they dropped that cross into a hole that was 4 to 5 feet deep, and as it dropped with a thud, His bones came out of joint. The nails ripped His wrists and His feet, and He hung there. And I want you to know, what his words were as he hung there in all of that pain. He said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing. And I want you to know, young person, whoever's watching, Jesus loved you like no one else has ever loved you. You see, he didn't deserve to die. He was innocent. He was the Son of God. He had never done anything wrong. And yet he died for you and for me. In fact, the Bible says not only did he die, but he was separated from his Father in heaven. The Bible says as he hung on the cross, he cried out with a loud voice as he gave up the ghost. He said, Father, or my God, why have you forsaken me? And it was the first time ever that Jesus called his Father God. And why did he call him God? Because he lost relationship with his Father for the first time in all of eternity. And why did he lose relationship with his Father God? So that you could have relationship that the Father lost with you through the sin of Adam and through your sin. And I want you to know that Jesus paid the penalty. He shed his blood and he went to hell so that you wouldn't have to have your blood shed, so that you wouldn't have to suffer eternally in hell, so that you could be forgiven. You know, Jesus walked up to a guy named Nicodemus one time, and Nicodemus asked him, he said, Jesus, how can I get into this kingdom of God? And Jesus looked back at Nicodemus and he said, Nicodemus, you must be born again. And Jesus says to you right now, you must be born again. You see, you can't make it with the life you're living right now. You need a life from Jesus. You need forgiveness. Why do you feel that guilt in your life? It's because you're not right with God. With all that Jesus has done for you, all that he's done for you, how could you reject everything that God has done? Don't reject him. Give Jesus a chance to prove himself. You've tried relationships. Maybe you've tried drugs. Maybe you've tried cults. Maybe you've tried other religions. Jesus is saying, try me. Let me have a chance in your life and let me prove myself to you. I want you to bow your head. I want to pray with you right now. Father, I ask you right now for everyone that's watching that Jesus, you would prove yourself to them, that you would love them, that you would forgive them, that you'd give them a chance, hallelujah, to live for you. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for bringing new life to everyone that needs it that's watching this program right now. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. We love you. Live your life for Jesus. He gave his life for you. We'll see you next time.